beautiful, sparkling day along the coast in Plymouth and around the region. It is mostly sunny and 38 degrees. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Gail Hoff, filling in for Anthony today. Making headlines at this hour, a young woman is shot inside her car last night in Dorchester. Police are now looking for a suspect. Loved ones gather to say goodbye to a Mattapan couple murdered in Haiti amid reports there may be a local connection to that killing. And concerns that a bad batch of heroin on Boston streets is the cause of numerous overdoses. A lot of news to tell you about today, but first let's get a quick update on our weekend weather forecast. Dave Epstein is in for Mark today. Hi, Dave.
Hello, Gail. It's a beautiful afternoon across southern New England. Temperatures fairly typical for what we'd expect for the middle of December. And we have a lot of sunshine, though the winds are kicking up a little bit, making it feel colder than it actually is. There are some snow showers on radar to the north of us. Take a check. We find them very heavy snow now up in Burlington, but it's a quick blast as some colder air starts to come at us. And that will really happen in earnest by tomorrow afternoon. Temperatures outside right now, well, take a look. They're generally in the 30s over all of New England. We find temperatures between about 37 and 38 degrees. And the quick check at the Pat Steelers game this afternoon, about 40 degrees with a west wind, 15 to 20, maybe a stray snow flurry. That would be about it. Gail?
Good forecast for this afternoon's game. Okay, thanks very much. We appreciate that update. In the news, a Roxbury woman is hospitalized this midday after being shot in Dorchester last night. Police found 22-year-old Stacy Williams on the hood of her car just after 11:30 last night. They say multiple shots were fired through the passenger door window of her car. The woman's condition isn't being released at the family's request this midday. Police have not made any arrests in that shooting. And police have yet to make an arrest in another shooting that's devastated many teens in the Boston area. A 16-year-old was shot and killed Thursday night. He became the city's first juvenile victim in 29 months. Last night at Boston City Hall, a Christmas party was held for the city's teenagers, giving them a chance to reflect on the tragedy.
Teens came bearing gifts for tots. They also came with heavy hearts last night. Given the season of love and sharing, it seemed a tragic twist that this Christmas dance would bring a moment of silence for the city's first juvenile homicide in nearly 2.5 years.
So many people talking about it, and it's so sad that after this long period of time, Boston now has broken our record.
Well, when something like this happens, it makes you think again about it and to like make you work harder.
Work harder to keep kids safe. 16-year-old Eric Paulding was shot to death in Dorchester Thursday night while standing outside his girlfriend's apartment on Wilbert Circle. Reportedly, a neighborhood rivalry between two groups of teens led to the shooting. Now the mayor and city's police commissioner are vowing to double their efforts to prevent another such tragedy.
One life lost is one too many. What we must take from this tragedy is a determination to redouble our efforts.
Boston's become a national model for other cities trying to cut down on juvenile homicides by giving kids a place to go, by police working with community leaders and clergy, and companies offering additional summer jobs and after-school programs. All of these have helped.
If we have more stuff like this, kids have places to go, they meet other kids, and it gets better.
Despite this recent shooting, the overall homicide rate in Boston has dropped to a 30-year low. A Taunton man is under arrest today, charged with driving under the influence of alcohol in a crash that has left three teenagers in the hospital this midday. Police say 21-year-old Jay Wright was speeding when he lost control of his car. That happened shortly after 11 o'clock last night. He hit a tree on Tremont Street. 17-year-old David Keeler and Carrie Silva, both of Taunton, are in critical condition at Beth Israel Hospital this midday. Another teen, Crystal Poirier, is hospitalized at Massachusetts General Hospital. Today, friends and family have gathered to mourn the deaths of a Mattapan couple killed last week in Haiti. Now a top Haitian official says there may be a Massachusetts connection to the killing of Willie and Alicia Mercier. Haitian consul Jean Genoux told the Boston Globe that someone from Boston may have told bandits that Mrs. Mercier was carrying $30,000 when she landed in Port-au-Prince. The Merciers are in Haiti to put the finishing touches on a retirement home. Funeral services are being held today in Mattapan. A Burlington hospital has closed its surgical intensive care unit to new patients because of a spread of a common bacteria. Public health officials say a stomach bacteria called Klebsiella has infected 5 patients at the Leahy Hitchcock Medical Center. That's happened in the past 6 weeks. The patients are being held in isolation, and a hospital spokesperson says they are expected to make a full recovery. Hospital staff are taking extra precautions to prevent the spread of the bacteria. People are being warned to take caution after a rabies scare in Lynn. Health officials are treating about 40 people who came into contact with a puppy that was infected with rabies. A female husky was apparently attacked by a skunk and has been put to sleep. Officials are emphasizing the need to be careful with wild animals.
It's bizarre that this dog could have passed on rabies to either other animals or to human beings.
Probably slight, but even in looking at small risks, we want to make sure people are protected. We've known of no cases of rabies in humans in association with this particular outbreak of raccoon rabies.
Officials in Lynn are looking for a man and 3 small children who played with the dog last month, not knowing that it had rabies. And a warning today that an increase in the number of drug overdoses in the city of Boston may be the result of a bad batch of heroin. Health officials have posted an advisory warning that 8 overdoses of intravenous heroin have occurred in the last 2 days in Boston.
You know, the nasty side effect of heroin overdoses, it makes you stop breathing and it can stop your heart. In fact, 6 people in the last 2 weeks have suffered from cardiac and respiratory arrest as a result of heroin.
Officials say at least 1 person in the past 2 weeks has died from a heroin overdose. A member of the MIT fraternity where a freshman pledge died of alcohol poisoning is refusing to cooperate with a police investigation. Phi Gamma Delta treasurer Daniel Herman says he will not turn over the fraternity's financial records. Prosecutors want to know if the fraternity did indeed purchase the alcohol supplied to Scott Krueger the night he died. But Herman, a 21-year-old MIT student, fears prosecutors will use the documents to incriminate him in the death of Scott Krueger. Louise Woodward will be staying in the Bay State for the holidays. A request to leave with one of her attorneys has been denied by Judge Hiller Zobel.
To the extent that the motion is directed to my discretion, I decline to allow it.
And the convicted au pair is staying at the home of her attorney. The attorney's name, Elaine Whitfield Sharp. They wanted to travel to California for the holidays, but yesterday Judge Hiller Zobel ordered that she stay in Massachusetts while both sides appeal his reduction of Woodward's verdict. Earlier, Zobel denied Woodward's request to go home to England for the holidays. And still to come on News Center 5 this midday, an annual Christmas tradition comes to Symphony Hall. Holiday Pops is next.
Closed caption funding is provided by your neighborhood Dunkin' Donuts. Something fresh is always brewing here.
Out in the turquoise sea, somewhere between your imagination and what's real, there is an island, Barbados, just beyond your imagination. For information, call us or your travel agent.
You buy a bigger house to make your life easier. Now you need bigger furniture to fill your bigger house. That makes your life harder. But you find someone who gives you a big loan and makes your life easier. But as you're enjoying the big furniture, the bigger roof on your bigger house brings a big leak, making your life harder. So you find someone who repairs the leak and makes your life easier. But there's one little thing. Your big house has a big pest problem. That makes your life a lot harder.
Make your life easier. Use the Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages. It's life. Listed alphabetically.
This holiday, Friendly's unlocks the flavor of our new combination dinners. The new tender steak and shrimp combination. The plump chicken and shrimp combination. Or the flaky haddock and steak. And when you order any of these perfect combinations, you'll get a classic Jubilee Roll Sundae absolutely free. A free sundae with any dinner at Friendly's.
For Christmas and all year round, nothing escapes the power of a dirt devil.
Hi, I'm Sherry Stewart. I run Exxon's Baytown Refinery. We offer 3-octane grades. Which is right for you? Most cars will run properly on regular octane. So check your owner's manual and stop by Exxon for this helpful pamphlet.
You're watching News Center 5, Midday. Coverage you can count on with Anthony Everett, meteorologist Mark Rosenthal, and Ed Harding on sports. Now, News Center 5 continues.
It's the time of year when a treasured holiday tradition returns to Symphony Hall. For the 24th season, the Holiday Pops concert series will delight audiences with the sounds of Christmas. News Center 5's Peter Henderson reports.
Now, you may well hear some of these same songs when you're out mall shopping, but somehow they sure sound a lot better at Symphony Hall. And there is something about this music that even Scrooge himself would find soothing.
We have memories that are bound up with music, and they go all the way back to our childhood. And I think going to a concert like this evokes all those things for all of us. It's my favorite time of the year.
The concert series continues through the holiday season. Catch it if you can.
You can catch another Pops highlight this weekend. Channel 5 will broadcast a special Holiday at Pops concert featuring Rosemary Clooney and hosted by Chronicle's Mary Richardson. That is Sunday night at 9 o'clock. Well, if you are headed to the Arsenal Mall to do some holiday shopping this weekend, you'll see the old scoreboard from the Boston Garden has a new home now. That's right, the scoreboard that used to hang above the Celtics basketball court. Now it hangs above the food court at the Arsenal Mall in Watertown. On hand for yesterday's unveiling were a number of the Celtics and Bruins greats. And for authenticity, the mall's owners have installed a parquet floor and an ice rink. Design, that is, right beneath the board.
Just saw a quick shot of Johnny Busick, and I think he's the best right wing in the organization right now.
I would take, yeah. Let's just take his word for it.
Well, no.
You're not going to catch me today, by the way.
We'll catch you at what?
You're just not going to catch me.
All right, okay, we'll talk football. The Patriots, you remember all that problem in the middle of the year? You remember all that, right? Yes. Forget about it. They win the rest of the year. They're at least the number two seed in the playoffs. It's all pretty good right now. Stay with us.
Dear Mom, camp is rough. Being out in the wild sure makes a kid hungry. But the sandwiches we got just aren't enough. It makes me homesick for you and a hot bowl of Campbell's tomato soup.
Nothing turns an ordinary sandwich into a hot, satisfying meal like rich, wholesome Campbell's tomato soup.
Mom?
I brought you something for those sandwiches.
Wow, tomato soup. You're the best, Mom.
Campbell's makes everything.
Better. Imagine this extraordinary place. Russell's has a gift shop, flower and candle shop, and fun toy shop. Come enjoy the most beautiful Christmas shop you've ever seen. Open evenings till 9 and Sundays 9 to 5:30.
I'm Elizabeth Russell from Russell's Garden Center in Waylands.
Virtually everyone wishes they could play an instrument. Hi, I'm Fred Bramante. At Daddy's, we help make wishes come true.
With tons of new and used music products, the best prices in the U.S., free double warranty, and we love trade-ins.
Only at Daddy's Junkie Music.
The minty mouthwash that tastes a little too medicine-y can leave your breath smelling a little too medicine-y.
Ooh. We still
are. 8 o'clock.
Like a breath of fresh medicine.
Who wants a minty mouthwash that smells so medicine-y? Get kissably close with Scope. The tingle tells you it kills bad breath germs. As many as the leading medicine-y mouthwash, the minty taste tells you how minty fresh your breath can be. Get kissably close with Scope.
Do you mind if we pop in for the holidays?
Join Keith Lockhart, the Boston Pops Orchestra, the Tanglewood Festival Chorus, and Anthony Clark as Rosemary Clooney lights up the house.
And bright.
It's Holiday at Pops. There's no place like home for the holidays. And this year, we're coming to yours. Don't miss Holiday at Pops this Sunday at 9.
Right here on Channel 5.
Live with Ed Harding, this is SportsCenter 5.
Because of the sports world, we like to keep these things simple. It all boils down to this. If the Patriots beat the Steelers in Foxborough this afternoon, New England clinches a playoff spot. And if they are going to win today, they need to slow down a fellow they call the bus. We go to the videotape. Who is the bus? He is 36 and black, Jerome Bettis, who admits to 260 pounds, who runs like a truck. He has speed, runs like a bus, has speed. Imagine trying to hit that thing, trying to tackle it, but he's got a gentle side. The guy is a bowler. He's got a 200 average. He doesn't bowl candle pins, so it doesn't count.
When you're tackling, when you're by yourself, you just got to try to make the tackle. It's not a matter of how can you make him fall or whatever. You just got to try to get him down. Yeah, that's it. It's not a matter if he lands on you, so be it. I mean, that may happen.
If he lands on you, you go, ouch. By the way, the Patriots, even if they lose, they still can clinch a playoff spot this weekend. Even if they do lose to the Steelers, if the Jets lose tomorrow, then New England is in the playoffs regardless of what happens today. But if New England wins, they are in the playoffs. There are no losers when you go to Fenway Park. There are no losers when you consider Pedro Martinez. No losers when you consider a six-year deal worth about $77 million that could reach $90 million.
I feel happy because some...
Very happy.
You never imagine the things I can do with all that money that I can feel ashamed of. And that you can include helping a lot of people. Most of that money, I know it's going to go to my future and the future of my family, but some of it is going to help some people, especially in the schools and baseball fields and stuff like that back home and everywhere I can. All the attention I'm getting and all the high hopes that I see in the people's eyes for just being here, imagine if we win. I guess they will turn the city upside down if we win the World Series here.
You don't know the half of it, Pedro. By the way, as a Red Sox fan, you will absolutely love the guy. He has an infectious smile. He has a ton of personality. He is quite genuine. You will just love it. And he's also a pretty good pitcher, which helps. We go to the videotape. Celtics played last night against the Washington Wizards in the Fleet Center. This team used to be the Washington Bullets. Celtics in white. Three. Walker right at the shot clock. Got it. Watch the sequence here. Get it up. Get it from Mercer to Billups, off glass and in. Last night, the Celtics pressed for 48 minutes. Washington could not respond, and the Celtics outscored them 28-10 in the fourth quarter. Walker with the shot and the dipsy-doo, and Chauncey Billups will finish off the three in the final sequence. 97-88, Celtics with a well-played win over the Washington Wizards last night at the Fleet Center. They're in Detroit tonight.
Okay, thank you very much. Oh, I'm so happy. I love that. Talk about the ultimate understatement. $90 million, and he says, I'm so happy. You'll be so happy when you hear the weekend weather forecast. That's coming up after the break. But first, today's Women's Health Report.
I'm Mary Alice Williams with the Women's Health Alliance, your health information resource. Migraines are no longer the mystery they once were, and several new drugs, as well as herbal and natural remedies, can help.
It's difficult to describe the pain other than absolutely excruciating.
Is it tender in there?
Ashram Markowitz is one of the roughly 16 million Americans, 70% of them women, who suffer migraine headaches each year. But new drugs that affect brain chemicals are making life more bearable for migraine patients like Ashra.
Unlike prior medications, these don't have to be taken at the premonition of a headache, but they are actually more effective when the headache is underway or even full-blown.
Migraines are thought to be hereditary, caused by an oversensitivity of the nervous system to various triggers. These may include alcohol, food preservatives, stress, bright lights or odors, as well as hormonal changes linked to a woman's menstrual cycle.
People have turned to herbal remedies like feverfew or supplementations like magnesium or vitamin B complex.
Migraine sufferers should see a doctor for guidance and begin to keep a diary of what brings on their headaches.
That information can help both the patient and a physician identify the triggers that might set off a migraine.
Get the facts you need by joining the Women's Health Alliance at 1-800-4-WOMEN-1.
Yanni, live in concert with his band and symphony orchestra in a spectacular new show. A compelling and moving musical experience you'll remember forever.
Yanni, live for one night only, January 26th at the Centrum.
A night of favorites and music from his new album, Tribute.
Reserve seat tickets on sale Monday at noon at the box office, Ticketmaster, or by phone.
Don't miss the timeless music of Yanni.
Virtually everyone wishes they could play an instrument. Hi, I'm Fred Bramante. At Daddy's, we help make wishes come true. With tons of new and used music products, the best prices in the U.S., free double warranty, and we love trade-ins. Only at Daddy's Junkie Music.
The Hartwell House Restaurant in Lexington is the Boston area's premier destination for excellence in fine dining, weddings, and business or family functions. Please call 862-5111. Now accepting reservations for New Year's Eve.
See the all-new Discover Stars on Ice, presented by Smuckers. Olympic gold is coming. Live on the ice, Christy Yamaguchi, Scott Hamilton, Torval and Dean, Paul Wiley, Kurt Browning, Ekaterina Gordieva, and more. The most exciting, exhilarating, extraordinary night of the year. March 12th at Worcester's Centrum Center. Tickets available now at the Center Box Office, Ticketmasters, or charged by phone. Celebrate Discover Stars on Ice, presented by Smuckers.
Baby face, you've got the cutest little baby face. There's not another one to take your place, my little
A baby place, Route 9 Natick. We've got everything for the baby in your life.
You sure have
information about the HealthBeat Project is available on the World Wide Web at www.wcvb.com. Get the information you need to take charge of your health.
Mark Rosenthal and the Weather Center 5 forecast.
I mean, maybe one of the few people out there hoping for snow, especially by the time Christmas comes along. Of course, it's 12 days away. We have a ways to go, but...
That's true. We do have a ways to go. I don't think we have anything in the foreseeable future, but things can change, as you well know. Oh, yeah. And boy, do we have changes upcoming over the next 4 days, I'll tell you, especially in terms of temperatures. Speaking of which, that's where we'll start this afternoon with our temperatures at 39 degrees in Boston, 39 also in Portsmouth, Worcester at 32, Falmouth at 37 degrees. Indeed, it's a very cool afternoon, but fairly typical for this time of year. Plenty of sunshine as well. Winds between about 15 and 20 miles an hour. That will hold true right through the Patriots game. So if you are headed down there or already down there, what you see is what you will get. There are some snow showers back to the west of here, all in association with one cold front that will sweep through later on this afternoon. There's another one that's far north of that, and that is racing southward, and that is going to usher in the coldest air so far we have seen this season, and that will be with us for tomorrow night into the first part of Monday, and then that is quickly out of here, so lots of quick changes. Here's the first one, this first frontal system, that's the one that goes through today. Some very heavy snow now across the mountains of, say, Vermont, New Hampshire, and entering the western Maine mountains. We could see a stray flurry here this afternoon, but that should be about it. I am not looking for any squalls or any heavy snow. Now, tomorrow morning, the second front is back where about the first one is right now. Behind that, it gets very, very cold. This will sweep through here during the day. We may see a snow squall with this tomorrow afternoon. It would only last a short amount of time if we got it, but certainly very cold. Snow squalls in the mountains. Not a great day for skiing because of all the wind and the bitter cold. Wind chills will be about 20 to 30 below zero up across ski country tomorrow. Tomorrow's highs, there's the pocket of very cold air. Tomorrow's highs in southern Canada, southeastern Canada, only in the lower teens, and some of that air, a piece of it will get in here by Monday morning, well below zero across all of northern New England. We'll be about 14 degrees downtown, and as soon as you get away from the city, it's going down into the single digits, so a very cold Monday morning. However, as I said, it will not last long. The bitter cold air pushes into Maine Monday afternoon. We bump into the 20s, and the milder air will be back in here for Tuesday and Wednesday. So lots of quick changes. Here we go with the forecast. It spells them all out. We started out with this afternoon. Frontal system number one comes through with perhaps a flurry late. Temperature around 40 degrees. That should do it. Then for tonight, partly cloudy skies, 25 to 30. Tomorrow, frontal system number two comes through. Maybe another flurry, turning very cold late in the day. And the five-day outlook shows the coldest day we've had so far this season on Monday, not getting out of the 20s. Morning lows in the teens in the city, but single digits just away. And then we warm up Tuesday and Wednesday. So there you go. Kind of a roller coaster ride of temperatures. Bundle up Sunday night. Okay. Wait till that'd you feel cool. This.
All right. Thanks. Well, for keepers of lighthouses along New England's coastline, visitors can be few and far between. But each year at this time, a jolly old soul drops by with a little holiday cheer, bearing gifts of gratitude. Santa Claus flew via helicopter from Boston to Plymouth, or Plymouth to Boston, I should say, visiting all the lighthouses today. The Christmas tradition began 7 decades ago when an airplane pilot got lost in a snowstorm on the Maine coast. It was the beacons of 7 lighthouses that guided him to a safe landing. He returned a few days later with gifts for the lighthouse keepers who saved his life. And it is a tradition that is carried out to today.
Good story.
It is. It's wonderful. We appreciate you joining us for this midday. And, of course, we'll be back at 6 o'clock. Have a great afternoon.
We're a few miles from the accident scene because Route 24 South in that part of Fall River is still closed down. About 8:30 tonight, police started receiving frantic cell phone calls from motorists saying someone was driving the wrong way on Route 24 South. And within 15 seconds of those first calls, there was a collision.
This is the pickup truck. Police say 4 people were inside, 2 men and 2 women. Both the driver and the passenger behind the driver were killed. The other 2 passengers, also a man and woman, were critically injured. A 3rd car was struck from behind by the 1st car. Police say miraculously no one in that vehicle was seriously injured. Debris from the accident was spread out all over Route 24. It took more than 2 hours to remove the bodies from the car. State Police accident reconstruction teams were on scene. Their preliminary investigation so far shows no evidence of alcohol in the pickup truck.
Now an update on the conditions of those 2 passengers. A male was taken to Charlton Hospital. He is being evaluated in the emergency room trauma unit there. The female passenger was med-flighted to Beth Israel Hospital in Boston. Now Route 24 southbound near Route 79 is going to be closed for most of the night while police conduct their investigation. We'll have the latest on the condition of the 2 survivors tomorrow morning at 5 a.m. For now, reporting live in Raynham, I'm David Robichaux, News 4 New England. Jack, back to you.
All right, David, thank you. Well, if you were at a local mall today, you already know the Christmas shopping rush is on. There are only 10 shopping days left before Christmas, and retail stores around New England have been packed. Until this weekend, many stores were reporting sluggish sales, with more people browsing rather than buying. But things have picked up, and you can expect next weekend to be even busier. Still, economists say stores need a lot of business over the next 10 days to salvage this year's shopping season. Police say they finally stopped a massive shoplifting ring. More than $100,000 in merchandise was allegedly stolen from one Brookline store. Police say it's the biggest holiday shoplifting spree they've ever seen. The hit-or-miss clothing store in Brookline was duped by 10 women, 3 of them employees of the store. The women stole everything from clothing to candy. A police sting operation was set up to catch the female thieves after store management noticed a large decrease in inventory.
It was almost like a 5-minute sale that you could take anything you wanted. People were just bringing stacks of clothing up. The employees were taking the sensors off, bagging them up, and people were going as fast as they could get up to the counter and get it out of there. They were taking it away.
Police believe the women were going to ship some of the stolen merchandise out of the country. The suspects will be arraigned tomorrow on charges of larceny and conspiracy. A glimmer of hope tonight for a breakthrough in the frosty relations between Iran and the United States. Iran's new president called today for a dialogue with the people of the United States in the not-too-distant future. The offer could prove to be the moderate president's biggest gamble in his effort to try to steer Iran away from the influence of the hardline clergy. There's also some positive news coming from the UN weapons inspectors in Iraq. Inspectors and Iraqi officials met for 2 hours today, and there's some hope tonight that the dangerous standoff over inspections at restricted sites may be close to ending. This may include an agreement to enter Saddam Hussein's presidential palaces. The murder of Boston youth Eric Paulding remains a mystery tonight. No arrests have been made yet. Earlier this evening, friends and family gathered for a vigil in the 16-year-old's memory. They walked with candles to retrace Eric's last steps. He was gunned down Thursday night on his way to his girlfriend's house. On the spot where he died, the plea for an end to violence.
What are you doing to help your life? What are you doing to live out Eric's life that he did not have a chance to live? 16 years he only had to live, but you have a lifetime today. What will you do in regards to his legacy and memory?
Police Commissioner Paul Evans, an area minister, suggested the youth centers be kept open late and through the holidays. They emphasized the need for kids to have a place to go during what they called a very vulnerable time. Police are still looking for help in this murder case. If you have any information, you're asked to call the Boston Police Crime Stoppers, 1-800-494-TIPS. Tonight, Lions on the Lookout. If you're the parent of a young child, you certainly buckle them up in a child safety seat. But what if that seat you're using has been recalled and you don't even know about it? As consumer reporter Paula Lyons explains, the information is available on the Internet.
Matthew is Bob and Kathy Zurich's second child, but just as precious as their first, so they made sure he always rode in this child's safety seat, the one his older brother used 7 years before.
And recently, he has been able to get out of it.
Matthew was slipping the strap right out of this well-worn clip, leaving him completely unprotected. When Bob and Kathy tried to find a new clip, they found Renolux was out of business. Then a friend suggested Bob look for help on the internet.
What helped a lot is when we found the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration website.
The NHTSA site is where Bob learned their safety seat had been recalled.
There was an issue with the not only the clip, but also the covering here, which was not passing the flame retardant tests.
Astonished by the sheer number of recalls on the website, Bob emailed everyone in his company. Jordan Olin was one of several colleagues who checked out the same site and found he was using a recalled car seat too.
Some good Samaritan had left a note saying, "Did you know that the car seat that you're using for your infant has been recalled?" So we were not aware at all.
The federal government recalls dozens of child safety seats each year, but it has always had trouble getting the word out to parents.
Or more importantly, says the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, getting parents to respond.
Compliance, I would estimate, is no better than 50% and probably worse than that on child safety seats.
Why? Safety advocates like Ellen Friedman cite the failure of parents to register their seats.
This is the only way the manufacturer can identify who you are and what seat you've purchased. Most people don't fill this out.
With our newest one, we did that right away.
Bob and Kathy say they have not only learned that lesson, they've also learned that today's safety seats are much improved. And how does Matthew like his new one?
He's adjusted well. Yeah. He's happy in it. We're all happy with it.
The bottom line, if you have an older child safety seat you've never registered or was given to you by friend or family member, take the time to find out if it's ever been recalled. Do that by calling NHTSA's hotline at 1-800-424-9393. That's 1-800-424-9393. Or by logging on to their website at www.nhtsa.dot.gov. Paula Lyons, News 4, New England.
Well, there's no doubt about it. There's no party like this party. It's an event, if you'll pardon the pun, steeped in tradition. 100 costume characters and free tea all day. The 224th anniversary party for America's most famous protest. The Boston Tea Party. And today, the Boston Tea Party Shop and Museum reenacted the actual dumping of that tea into our beloved Boston Harbor. 224 years ago today, the Patriots of Boston protested the British taxation of tea by dumping the whole shipload right into our harbor. Coming up next on News 4 New England, a bacteria outbreak at the Leahy Clinic in Burlington. New safety precautions following our exclusive report. Tonight, he's just Elton John, but soon you'll be calling him Sir Elton.
Hi, I'm Barry Burbank in the weather office, and we're in the deep freeze now, but it isn't going to last very long. I'll have the forecast coming up.
Hi, I'm Bob Lobel. Did Jack Williams say something about dumping the Patriots into the Boston Harbor? No, but it might be one of the subjects coming up on Sports Final Plus. Eckersley, Pedro Martinez, and the coach of the Boston Bruins. What a big show we have coming up for you. We'll see you then.
Closed captioning sponsored by Polar Beverages. Since 1882, Polar captures the flavor of life.
Final panel. Check. Uh-oh.
Constant support.
Is there a problem, Jim? Over.
Mission critical connectivity. But enough about the computers Dell built for NASA. What can we build for your company? To find out, give us a call. With the Intel Pentium 2 processor, Dell, the number one supplier of desktop PCs to corporate America.
All they want for Christmas is Tommy Hilfiger. All you need is Macy's. All he wants for Christmas is a Movado timepiece. All you need is Macy's.
Take it from a water expert. If you're buying a filter for your drinking water, remember, not all filters are the same. Compared to Brita, Pure removes the microorganisms Brita can't. And Pure removes 98% of lead. It even shuts itself off when the filter needs changing. Pure uses a higher level of technology for great-tasting, healthier water. So until your city gets one of these, get Pure.
A higher level of clean is Pure.
Ring in 1998 with North America's largest New Year's celebration as WBZ 4 and WBZ News Radio 1030 present First Night 98. Come to the Family Festival, the Grand Procession, the ice sculptures, the performances, all the New Year's festivities that Boston has to offer. First Night 98, brought to you by Bell Atlantic, your local Honda dealer, and the Boston Globe. Call 542-1399 or visit firstnight.org.
Stabilizer to the Sisprusian CPX? Frankly, I don't need a higher form of intelligence to make smart decisions. No offense. Now during the Chevy Make Your Money Cab year-end event, the Smart Buy is Cavalier. With features usually found on more expensive cars for half the price. Plus now, get 2.9 APR financing or cash back on Cavalier. Check out great offers on other 98 Chevy cars and trucks. You want to look smart? Get a Cavalier. You want to be smart? Get to the Chevy Make Your Money Cab year-end event now. And save big.
Now, news for New England on WBZ-TV.
A follow-up now to our exclusive story Friday night about a bacteria outbreak at the Leahy Clinic in Burlington. Doctors and nurses are taking stricter precautions since five patients became infected with a drug-resistant bacteria. Doctors and nurses are now using double gloves and extensively washing their hands between seeing patients. The five infected patients have been isolated, and the surgical intensive care unit has been closed. Soon, Elton John will be Sir Elton. The New York Post reports that Queen Elizabeth will knight the singer next month. John says he's thrilled by the great honor. He'll be knighted under his real name, Reginald Kenneth Dwight, and will join other British pop knights like former Beatle Paul McCartney. John is being honored for his charity work, and by the way, Sir Elton John will be performing at the Fleet Center next year. Well, the first family is getting into the Christmas spirit tonight. The President, First Lady, and Chelsea Clinton were all on hand for the taping of a musical holiday special for TV, Christmas in Washington. The program also features actress Glenn Close, the group Hanson, and the U.S. Naval Academy Glee Club. Well, some unusual weather out there today. How's the week ahead shaping up? Barry Burbank joins us right after the break. Also coming up, the hottest new show in town is Chicago. And Joyce tonight talks to one of the show's stars, Jasmine Guy, who happens to be a Boston native.
For over 150 years, my family's been making furniture here in New York State. About 10 years ago, we made a decision to relocate part of that business to North Carolina. Today, things in Albany have changed. This is the place our people can call home. This is the place our people can be prosperous. We're proud to be back in New York State.
We're cutting taxes, red tape, and regulations, making it easier for you to do business in New York State. Give us a call and find out more about our business programs.
Life is full of little surprises. But at Pheasant Lane Mall, we believe your shopping experience shouldn't be one of them. Pheasant Lane Mall. What else do you need?
Connect the numerical Athenium stabilizer to the Sisprusian CPX? Frankly, I don't need a higher form of intelligence to make smart decisions. No offense. Now during the Chevy Make Your Money Count year-end event, the Smart Buy is cavalier. With features usually found on more expensive cars for half the price. Plus now, get 2.9 APR financing or cash back on Cavalier. Check out great offers on other 98 Chevy cars and trucks. You want to look smart? Get a Cavalier. You want to be smart? Get to the Chevy Make Your Money Count year-end event now. And save big.
Be an angel. Get an angel and help the kids at Children's Hospital. Wing your way to any Filene's to purchase this angel for just $10. This lovely angel ornament makes a wonderful gift for most anyone at holiday time. And be sure to tune in to the WBZ Children's Hospital Telethon, Thursday, December 18th from 8 to 11 p.m. on WBZ4. All proceeds from the sale of these angels go to the WBZ Children's Hospital Fund. So be an angel and spread holiday cheer with Filene's.
Now you don't have to search the world for a perfect gift. Handmade in the tradition of ancient artists. It's Chia Pets and new Chia Heads. Chia Professor, Chia Clown, Chia Kid, and Chia Guy. It's easy. Soak your chia overnight. Spread the seeds, keep it watered, and watch it grow. Chia. It's a treasure of a gift. Collect them all. Chia Pets and Chia Heads, the pottery that grows.
Chia Pets and Chia Heads available at Ames, Walgreens, Bradley's, and Osco.
Now, weather on News 4 New England.
Good evening, everybody. What a day this has been. We had the sunshine this morning. We had rather vicious snow squalls go by, lasting 5 minutes, causing about near whiteout conditions in a few locations. Now it's down to 21. We have that big, beautiful, bright moon out there. Wind chill is zero as a northwest wind continues to gust, but not howling like it did earlier this afternoon when those squalls came through. That's a classic example of a snow squall in New England. We don't get them too often, but we sure got it this afternoon. Now it's down to the teens, north and west, even a 10 at Burlington. Nationally, this is what's going on. There's not much rain left in Florida. They had a lot over the last several days, up to a foot with flooding in the Tampa Bay, Orlando area and points north. Then they had snow in Jackson, Mississippi area and parts of central Mississippi over into Alabama. Some spots at 8 inches of snow today. Meantime, we watch this band of clouds right in here start to circulate and shift southeastward. So we'll be seeing some of that during tomorrow. But we are definitely in the deep freeze now. But it isn't going to last very long because on the backside of this front right in here, it is really warming up and that surge of warm air is headed our way. So the forecast for tonight, though, calling for that bright moonlight, a beautiful night to be inside looking out at, because we do have that just past full cold moon, it's called this month, appropriately. Wind chill temperatures down near zero, a few spots below. Now, there is going to be some cloudiness showing up in northern New England. Some of that will be heading southeast. We might see just a few scattered clouds by dawn. And we're looking at tonight's low temperatures going down just a little bit more from what they are right now. 19 in Boston, 15 Brockton to about 12 in Worcester, 10 in Nashua, 20 down in Hyannis. Then for tomorrow, we got the sunshine nice and bright for the most part, but in the morning, some cloudiness will start heading southeastward from northern parts of New England, so it will become partly cloudy. And that patchy cloudiness will last into the afternoon hours. The tide will be high late in the morning, west-northwest wind going west-southwest, not all that strong, 8 to about 18 miles an hour, no gust to 50 like we had today. And in terms of highs, we should be bouncing right back after a chilly start, up to 37 in Boston, 38 in Hyannis, and mid-30s through Worcester County. How about the morning commute? Sun rising 7:06. Sunrises continue to get later and later on until about the first week in January. 19 in Boston. There should not be any frost around tomorrow morning. The air is really that dry. So the forecast calling for bouncing to 36 tomorrow. Some patchy cloudiness showing up. Tuesday, a little bit of cloudiness. But look at this. Flirting with 50. Wednesday, into the 50s. Some cloudiness early Wednesday. Front moves by. Turns somewhat cooler in, later in the afternoon. And Thursday will be up in the 40s, so it looks like most of this week will be great, storm-free, nothing coming up, probably right into the upcoming weekend. How's that sound, Jack?
That sounds pretty good, Barry. Thank you. You know, the votes are in from the Boston Society of Film Critics on the year's best on the big screen. And L.A. Confidential gets the top awards for 1997. The critics voted L.A. Confidential the best picture of the year. Curtis Hanson voted best director. Kevin Spacey picked up nods as best supporting actor. Well, the hottest new show on Broadway is now here in Boston, and it's called Chicago. As Joyce Galevi tells us, it's a homecoming of sorts for one of the show's stars, Jasmine Guy, who was born in Boston.
Start the car, I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz.
Chicago is all sass and crackle. Anne Reinking's choreography, in the style of Bob Fosse, is brash and sexy. Angled hard bodies convey the shallow glint of a sex and celebrity mad culture.
It's funky and streetwise, and it has an edge to it. And so it does have a lot of sensuality.
Jasmine Guy plays the tough-talking Velma Kelly in Chicago. Just last year, she was in Boston playing another tough-talking character, Rizzo, in Grease.
Grease the lightning.
Guy says whether it's Grease or Chicago, there's nothing like being part of a hit show.
You can put the same amount of energy into a flop. You can put the same amount of energy into lines that will never be funny, into a show that will never make people happy. And you're just doing your job, but this is a great experience in that I know I'm gonna have a good time and I know the audience will.
Jasmine Guy was born in Boston and told us she's looking forward to having her New Bedford area relatives come see her at the Colonial Theater. And Guy is just one member of an extravagantly talented Chicago cast. The show is drop-dead dazzling, the best show I've seen all year. So, go see it. I'm Joyce Kilhawick, News 4, New England.
Drop-dead dazzling. That's what they're saying about the Jets in New York tonight. How about
drop
that?
Drop dead, dazzling. Yeah. Well, they're not saying drop dead because let me tell you something, folks. The Jets are still alive. Drop dead, not by a long shot. They're making this playoff picture very interesting, Jets. Right.
Steve Burton coming up with a whole lot of sports next.
This week on Sports Vinyl.
Patriots and Steelers. Pedro signs on and Eck comes home. Pat's Pete with Coach Burns.
Watch Sports Vinyl with Bob Lobel tonight at 11:35 on WBZ4. You need it.
To get to work.
You need it.
To be ready for the weather.
You need it.
To find out what's happening.
Right now, WBZ-TV4's got it.
Get it.
Watch News 4 New England this morning, weekday starting at 5 a.m.
What to buy? What to buy? I gotta get gifts. No.
Ugh.
Oh, no.
Help.
Yes.
This holiday season, Circuit City has the gifts for you, like Celine Dion's new album, Let's Talk About Love. With Celine Dion, Circuit City has gift-giving all wrapped up.
Ready for a number that can help? Whether you're investing for college or retirement, the Galaxy family of mutual funds at Fleet can help. They're designed with a goal of consistent performance for the long term. If you're ready to start, we're ready when you are.
A bright red tote in brilliant lip color, $15 with any Estee Lauder fragrance purchase. This holiday offer is now at Macy's.
A car should be dependable and ready when you need it. Maybe that's why 97% of Prism owners would go out of their way to recommend Prism to a friend. Introducing the all-new Chevrolet Prism. Relax. This is one great car. Brand new from Chevrolet.
Now, sports on News 4 New England.
Well, they say dark clouds pass with time. The Patriots have 8 days to put yesterday's loss behind them. But what hurts even more is that Tuna and the Jets won today with a 31-zip thrashing over Tampa Bay, keeping their own playoff hopes alive. Long day for Tony Dungy's Bucks at the Meadowlands. 3-0 in the early going when Tampa's Trent Dilfer gets picked off by former Patriot. That's right, former Patriot Otis Smith. He returns it 45 yards down the sideline, making it 10-0 J-E-T-S. A little later, it's Dilfer serving one up again to guess who? Mr. Smith again. Otis takes his second pick of the game and races 51 yards down the sidelines for the J-E-T-S score, making it 17-0 New York. But the Jets were just getting warmed up. Leon Johnson fields a kickoff on the 1 yard line, makes that inside the end zone and goes 101 yards. Down the sideline, no one is gonna catch him. Strutting his stuff into the end zone, the Jets bomb the Bucks, 31-0, improving to 9-6. Well, coming up on Sports Final tonight, we have a jam-packed show for you. We'll wrap up the Patriots-Steelers game and talk about the playoff possibilities. We'll focus in on the Red Sox newest acquisition, Pedro Martinez, and the act, Dennis Eckersley, will join us in studio. And don't forget Pat's Peak. Bruins head coach Pat Burns reveals the latest from Bruins camp. That Sports Final coming up in just a few moments. Rough day for Jimmy Johnson and his Dolphins against the Indianapolis Colts. Already 10-0 Indy, second quarter with Jim Harbaugh and Ken Dilger. Explode. Harbaugh to Dilger over the middle. 7 yard scoring strike, 17-0 Colts. These guys are just getting warmed up. After a Marino pick, Harbaugh finds Dilger all alone in the middle of the field for the 31-yard score. Where is the defense? Miami turned it over again a minute later. Harbaugh finds Dilger again. That's his third touchdown of the day, folks. Colts up 34-3 at the half. Now, just for good measure, Marshall Faulk rumbles in from 7 yards out, rounding out the scoring. Colts romp all over the Dolphins, 41-0. Falling to 9-6 and into a tie with the Jets and Patriots atop the AFC East. Now to Rich Stadium for the Bills and Jags. And it was all Jags early on. Mark Brunell scrambling, getting into the end zone for the 15-yard scoring strike. 7-0 Jags in the first. More Jags a little later on. Natron Means. He doesn't mean to do this, run right into a wall. But he does mean to do this, scoot into the end zone. 3 yard score, 14-0 Jags. Jacksonville holds on for the 2014 win over Buffalo and clinches a playoff berth in the process. Well, not exactly happy days out at the Metrodome today for the Vikings. Robert Smith gives the Viking faithful something to cheer about, ripping off the 22-yard run with some nice moves along the way. 7-0 Minnesota. 13-7 Vikings in the third when Barry Sanders gets loose. Loose, folks. Up the middle he goes, rumbling 60 yards down to the 5-yard line before being tackled from behind. But the Vikings defense holds. Now on fourth and goal from the one, Barry Sanders is just absolutely swallowed up. And the Lions turn it over on downs. The Lions have one last chance. With 6 seconds remaining in the game, Scott Mitchell hits Herman Moore on the stop route. The Lions pull out the 14-13 win, keeping their playoff chances alive and severely damaging those of the Vikings. Well, great day for the defending champion Green Bay Packers against Carolina. Scoreless in the first until Brett Favre finds Antonio Freeman, scooting 59 yards for the touch. 7-0 Pack. Favre and the boys were on fire in the first. Looking for more, they get more. Favre drilling to Robert Brooks, who takes a shot but still muscles his way in. 14-0 Packers in the first quarter. Green Bay wraps it up in the fourth. Aaron Hayden, the nice hesitation move in the backfield, then even prettier cut. He goes in for the score. Packers roll 31-10 over the Panthers, eliminating Carolina from playoff contention. Now to Cincy we go, where the boys are gone. 10-10 in the second quarter, when the Aegis Boomer Esiason finds Darnay Scott over the middle for the 48-yard touchdown, strike 17-10, Cincy. 24-10 Bengals in the third when Esiason strikes again, this time to David Dunn for the 32-yard score. Bengals hold on for the 31-24 win over the boys, officially eliminating the Cowboys from playoff contention. We have to take a quick time out right now, but when we come back, Roosevelt invades the Fleet Center. Stay with us.
This year, Buick introduced three more impressive new cars. Powerful, stylish, comfortable. New cars well worth celebrating. And that's what we're doing with Buick's three-way celebration. Now there are three different ways to celebrate. Choose 2.9% APR GMAC financing on every 98 Buick. Or choose low GMAC lease payments. Or take advantage of special cash offers on select models. Three ways to celebrate, one place. Your Buick dealer. During Buick's three-way celebration. But hurry, it ends soon.
Jets 57! It's a pretty simple rule. If you can't communicate clearly, things may not go quite as planned. Nationwide Wireless with 100% digital clarity and less background noise. From Sprint PCS, the clear alternative to cellular.
What makes a woman alluring? It's difficult to define, but impossible to resist. Every woman has her own special allure. And like a perfect memory, it lasts forever. Allure, the irresistible fragrance from Chanel at Macy's.
Presenting the Smart Clapper.
How smart could it be?
Clap twice to turn one appliance on or off, three times for another. It knows the difference. Plug two appliances into the Smart Clapper, then plug it into any outlet. Switch to Away for added security. It turns TV or lights on at the first sound it hears.
Clap on, clap off, clap on, clap off.
The Smart Clapper.
The Smart Clapper is available at Osco, Walgreens, Bradley's, and Kmart.
The Toyota Camry has been called a benchmark for all mid-price sedans. Automobile Magazine called Camry the best car built in America. It's America's favorite car. And to celebrate, Toyota's offering special leases and low APR financing on new Camrys, but only until January 5th. So see your Toyota dealer today and call Camry the best thing of all, yours.
Now, sports on News 4 New England.
Welcome back. The Commonwealth Classic. You know, it started 3 years ago between the UMass Minutemen and the BC Eagles on the parquet floor. We head to the Fleet Center, where UMass had won the first two meetings, and we're looking to make it three. Bruce Flint looking for his second Commonwealth crown, while BC's Al Skinner was coaching in his first. First half action, time running down on the shot clock for UMass. So Charlton Clark from downtown buries it. His prayer is answered. BC hanging tough early on. Javier Rodriguez with the drive and pretty dish to Costos Maglos. BC trail 33-25 at the half. Second half, Larry Kettner with the block shot down one end. South Boston's Monty Mack takes it down the other end. Mack finished with 20 points. UMass pulls away late in the second half. Clark with the drive and short runner in the lane for the